Good morning and welcome to Your Grace Daily Devotional. And I want to just dive into some very important things that are contained in the devotional. Today we're looking at commitment means that you will be accountable. What does that mean? When you say, I am committed to something without any form of evaluation or any form of accountability, it's not complete. Now, there are times when you will have to self-evaluate. But self-evaluation is usually not the best evaluation. Because when you self-evaluate, there may be gray areas that you may be missing. There may be blind spots that you may not see. And that's why it is important that there are healthy relationships in your life who will tell you what you may not want to hear sometimes. What I mean by that is that people who will say this and this and this, regardless of how you feel about it, who have your best interest at heart, you know, and that's one of the reasons why cultivating healthy relationship in the body of Christ is so vital, in the house of God is so vital, because when the text where we Ephesians 5 and 21 says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. God expects of us to be accountable because of what He does to our walk with the Lord, because He puts us in check. See, if you are left to evaluate yourself, you always get 100%. But when others who have your best interest at heart are able to say, okay, you need to improve this area, you need to do this, you need to do that, it's not always a judgment. No, it's an opportunity to grow. It's an opportunity to be the best that God has created you for. He says, be accountable out of reverence for Christ. So when you submit yourself for accountability or evaluation, it's for Christ, it's not for the person. When you make yourself vulnerable to the people that God has anointed over your life in such a way where you can talk to them and have them speak truth into your life, it's for your benefit, it's for your growth, it's for your increase. So the idea that, I'm only accountable to the Holy Spirit, I'm only accountable to God, I'm not accountable to anybody, it's just a language of hell. Or I do not believe in accountability. I do not believe in someone telling me what to do. That's just a language from hell, you know. And it shouldn't be named among us. Accountability is vital. It is so vital. And if you've been following us from the beginning of this month, we're looking at, the Spirit of God told us that this month is a month of commitment. And that's why in today's devotional, we're looking at commitment means that you're going to be accountable. You're going to be accountable. And that's what we're going to encourage you today. You know, the Bible said, submit yourself one to another. You know, be accountable to one another out of reverence for Christ. So I'm going to encourage you. Don't shy away from it. Now, you may not like it. You may not feel like doing it. You may not even subscribe to it. But if God's word says that you should be accountable to someone, then you should be accountable out of reverence for Christ, He says. In other words, the reason why you're doing what you're doing is out of your reverence for Christ. And if you do have reverence for Christ, you should do what He says. Jesus said, if you love me, do my word. And His word says, submit yourself one to another out of reverence for Christ. It is for your benefit. It's not to your disadvantage. Heeding godly counsel is not to your disadvantage. You know, heeding godly wisdom is not to your disadvantage. It's to your advantage. Now, you may have been holding on to something for so long and you're like, oh, there's something wrong with that. Nobody's saying that something's wrong with something. There's a better way of doing stuff. There's a higher life. There's a higher level of operation that God is calling you into. So just because you've held on to some things for so long and you're like, okay, it's not broken, why should I fix it? It's not about being broken and we're trying to fix it. This is not about trying to fix anything about you. This is a call to greater glory. This is a call to a higher living by the Spirit of God. And He's calling us to be accountable. He's calling us to submit ourselves to those that He's called us, that He's called over us. It is for our benefit, it's to our advantage. So I want to encourage you today, as you commit to whatever God has called you to do, also know that you have to be accountable. There's evaluation, and there's going to be correction. There's going to be instruction. All of that is not to your disadvantage. I can't say that enough, because a lot of times when we hear, just because of the way a lot of us have been raised, or because of the way society has presented the subject in a very negative light. But it's not to your disadvantage. It is to your advantage. It's to your progress. It's to the fulfillment of God's plan for your life. It's okay to be accountable. It is okay to be corrected. It's okay to be given instruction. It's okay. It is okay. Praise God. So read the devotional. It'll bless you, and make sure that you share with someone. Let someone participate in the devotion today just by sharing with them and say, hey, I got something that I just read. It's really blessed me, and I'd like for you to take a look at it. And I'm telling you, it's going to bless them tremendously. Praise God. Anyways, thank you again for joining us this morning or this afternoon from wherever you're watching us from. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your participation. Thank you for loving Jesus. Thank you for your prayer. Thank you for your giving. And thank you for showing your words that Jesus is Lord. God bless you.